Hey, Shalom. First and foremost, all praise and glory go on to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakak Wadash. Double honors on to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone that do rule exceptionally well. Also, Shalom, salutations, mercy, and blessings for all you sincere brothers that's out there that push this word with truth and with faith. My name is Thabawa Amoth of Great Millstone Northwest. I just want to take this time to just issue this stern warning, man, because we are entering into what is known as the final stretch. All right. So yesterday, or maybe possibly even the day before yesterday, today's date is Wednesday, December 11th. So it was either yesterday or it was either Tuesday or Monday. Definitely recent. There was a shooting. All right. That happened in Jersey City in New Jersey. And this is the information they're putting out now. It says Jersey City shooting. Suspect linked to Black Hebrew Israelite group. The Black Hebrew Israelite group have been labeled a hate group. The suspect wrote anti-Semitic and anti-police post, an official said. Okay. Another one says, this is off of somebody's Twitter. It says, breaking, gunmen who stormed kosher store in Jersey City identified as David Anderson and Francine Graham. Anderson was a follower of the Black Hebrew Israelite movement. There were postings connected to Anderson's social page and anti-police with anti-Jewish writings, WNBC. So right here in the New York Times, they put it straight up in the headline that he was linked to a Black Hebrew Israelite group. And that's how they're always going to label it, man. All right. They're always going to label it as a Black Hebrew Israelite thing, man. When even if you type in Hebrew Israelite like I did here on Google, the thing that comes up is Black Hebrew Israelite, man. All right, and they're constantly going to be pushing that out. And you see this, look at Hebrew Israelites, what we know about the fringe group by the New York Times. That says that's 4 hours ago. Jersey City, again, New York Times. All right, so they're really about to start coming after it. In Wikipedia, it's only listed as Black Hebrew, which I read through that Wikipedia. It's an entertaining read. It goes into a little bit of history from like the 1800s, the 1900s, about some groups that was here in America that was of Jakes, you know, Judites that was aware of being Israelites. Okay, so on and so forth, man. African Hebrew Israelites. See, they bring all kind of different slanderous types of names against us, man, because this is just the fulfillment of Esau having a short amount of time, man. All right, he's got to spread forth these lies, because this truth is the last thing Esau wants. All right, if all the Israelites was recognized was aware that they were actually of who they are, that means Esau wouldn't be able to get away with the kind of things that he's getting away with, man. All right, he wouldn't be able to keep us held down in the manner that he is, man, or that he's able to at this moment. All right. So that's the reason why Esau will never admit to what's going on with the Israelites here in America, man. All right. And it's not Black Hebrew Israelites. All right. There's 12 different tribes, man. There's 12 different tribes, not just one. All right. And there's three different tribes made up of dark skinned people, man, which actually any of the tribes can have somebody that's a dark skinned person. A lot of Northern Kingdom actually appear to be so-called Negroes, man. All right. So these people, they have a short time, man. They do not have the time frame that they think they had to be able to play around. All right, that's proven in the book of Revelation chapter 12, verse 12, which reads, therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he have but a short time. You see, hey, this man Esau Edom, he's about to pull all the stops, man. All right, he's about to pull all the stops because he's running out. He's running out of time, man. People are losing patience with him. These nations, the heathen nations, are ready to rise up against him. All right, you got Jake no longer dancing and tapping to his tune. Actually, nah, scratch that. A lot of Jake, majority of Jake is still tap dancing to this wicked ass dude's tune. You know, but majority, like, hey, you got an alarming rate of Israelite men recognizing who they are, man. All right. We are recognizing who we are. That's why they're going to continue to try to slander us, calling us Black Hebrew Israelites, or trying to link any little thing that happened in society, trying to link that back to The Israelites, man. And let me say this as well. If you are aware that you're an Israelite and you still go forth and pull some BS like this, go shoot up someplace, man, taking vengeance into your own hand rather than waiting on the Lord. Well, then, hey, when the Most High deals with you and the Most High takes you out, you can't blame nobody, man. All right. And when you don't receive those promises that you thought you was going to receive, you ain't going to have nobody to blame, man, because what you were supposed to do was wait on the Heavenly Father. All right. You're supposed to wait on the Heavenly Father. You're not supposed to be taking things into your own hands. All right. Let me just put that out there like that. Matter of fact, let me grab a scripture real quick. You know, let me grab man. Let me grab, what is that, Psalms 27? Psalms 27. I think it's Psalms 27. Talk about wait on the Lord. I say wait on the Lord. Maybe it wasn't Psalms 27. Oh, right here, 14. Psalms 27, verse 14. It says, wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. All right? So how do you get around that? We're supposed to be waiting on the Heavenly Father, man. All right, vengeance is the Lord's, as it's written multiple times within the scripture, man. Okay, so we ain't supposed to be taking nothing into our own hands. We are aware that this devil's coming down with that great wrath because he have a short time. Hey, his time, we want his time to be short, man. All right, you can't be losing patience the same time the devil's losing patience, man. You know, this is that you're supposed to be, if you see the devil losing patience, that's supposed to boost your endurance ever the more, because you know that we don't got that much more time to go, man. All right, this guy is moving quick. Esau is moving quick, man. All right, he's moving fast, man. He's moving fast towards his own destruction. That means that we are supposed to be likewise moving fast towards salvation, man. All right, which we don't have to do anything other than what was commanded of us, which is to feed the flock, man. To feed the flock, to go out there and tell the people what's going on. All right. Expose Esau, Edom, and all his wickedness that he's up to. Expose the wicked of our nation. All right. But also to tell our people who they are, to dispose of the lies that Esau has been telling them, man, to tell the truth about what the scriptures have to say, to actually preach Yahushai. OK, that's what we're commanded to do, man. All right. But we're entering into that time of Jacob's trouble, which is mentioned in Jeremiah, the 30th chapter, I believe it is. Jeremiah chapter 30, the time of Jacob's trouble. All right. Yep. This is Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 7. It says, alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. So if you're an Israelite, what the hell are you losing patience for, man? All right, we're in the final stretch, man. We're in, it's the, you know that song, it's the final countdown. And that's what we're in right now, man. We're in that final countdown. We're in the final stretch, man. This is no time to be losing patience, man. This is no time to be losing faith, because that's what happened. If this dude actually is who they say he was, and that he was actually following some Israelite group, that's what happened. The dude lost patience, man. Either one or two things. All right. Obviously, the guy didn't have a sincere faith, but either he was a novice, just found out everything and finding out this information. You know, it's written that oppression maketh the wise man mad. So he finally snapped. Either that happened, or two, this guy wasn't an Israelite at all, man. And they're just trying to pin that shit on us. All right. Those are the only ways, because if this was some dude that's been in this truth, that's been seasoned with the scriptures, there's no way he would have performed that type of action, man. All right, because it's written way too many times that we're supposed to wait on the Heavenly Father, and that we're not supposed to take vengeance into our own hands. Okay, it's written way too many times, man. All right, what's that? Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. Let me grab that real quick. Talk about leaning not on your own understanding. All right, just in case it was the possibility that this guy this guy was who they say he is. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5, it says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. The Heavenly Father ain't about to direct your path to go on a mass shooting spree, man. All right? When the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. How the hell do you suppose that the Heavenly Father is directing the paths, and you're going on a shooting spree, man? All right, using Esau Edom's blessing. That don't make no sense, man. Shooting cops and shooting anybody that's walking past and all this madness, man. Nah, man, the real men of the Lord is going to be waiting on the Heavenly Father, man. All right? The real men of the Lord is going to be doing as was commanded. All right? They're not going to be, we're not concerned with going out and trying to take these people's lives ourselves. All right? We know that the Heavenly Father, he already got everything already planned out, man. All right? He already has it all planned out. So there's no reason for us to try to take actions into our own hands. All right? One more scripture. I'm going to go ahead and close it out just to continue with what I was just saying. This is the book of Romans chapter, what was that? Romans 12 and 19, I think. Yep. It says, "Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto wrath, for it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord." So how's that guy going to be a Hebrew Israelite, or as they call it, a black Hebrew Israelite? How's he going to really be a Hebrew Israelite and he's not listening to the words of the Heavenly Father, man? He's not hearing it when the Heavenly Father said vengeance is his and that he's going to repay. All right, because the Most High can do something way more devastating to that person than what we could do. The most we can do is take his life. The Most High can put that person in torments, man. Most High can paralyze that person's body or torment their mind, turn them crazy. All right. Do you not remember that the Most High had Nebuchadnezzar? I believe it was Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, living like a wild animal. All right. Living like a wild animal for years, man. All right. Hey, the Most High can do a whole bunch of way more strenuous things than what we can hope to do, man. You know, so we got to leave it into the hands of the Lord. You know, yeah, you may want some judgment to happen to somebody. Pray on it, man. Ask the Heavenly Father to do it and keep it trucking. All right. Ask the Heavenly Father for it and keep moving, man. Don't be trying to take things into your own hands. Hey, but pretty much that's the point. I want to give that stern warning that, look, we're in that final stretch, man. Esau's going to be pulling out all the stops. He's going to be trying to come so he can try to silence this word, man. But it's too late already. All right. For the ears that this actually, the people that have ears to hear, this message is already reaching them, okay? They're already getting it. Jake is already getting it, all right? So it's too late for Esau to try to stop it now. Hey, pretty much that's the point. Lord willing, this has been edifying. Lord willing, the message has been received. Until next time, I'm saying Shalom.